Hi, I'm Adam, and I'm an information developer at GE Digital. Today I'm going to show you how to manage user roles in plant applications. In this demonstration, you will learn how to create and set permissions for user roles, as well as how to edit and delete existing roles. A role is a set of permissions required to perform various tasks. Plant applications users are assigned a role according to the actions they will perform. You must have access to the security application in order to manage roles within plant applications. Within Plant Applications, select the Security application and click the Roles tab. Any existing roles will be listed on these pages. To create a new role, click the plus sign. This will bring up the Create Role page. You are required to enter a name for the role. For this example, I will create a role called Demo Role. Once you've entered a role name, the Create button in the top right corner will be enabled. While you could create the role at this point, in this particular example, the role has no permissions and would be limited in its capability. You can enter a role description, however, you can leave this field empty if you want. Under the header Individual Roles, you will see the role categories for which you can set permissions. Work Order Execution controls the ability to execute work orders, create and/or consume material lots and add them to in-progress work orders, and to skip any optional operations. The second category is Work Order Management, which controls the ability to create, change, cancel, manually complete work orders, change lot identifiers, add produced material lots to work orders, whether the work order is in progress or is yet to be started, cancel a not started material lot, and clock off users. The time booking category lets you give users the right to edit the time booking records for other users. Comments will allow users to edit and delete other users' comments. The process order execution category controls if users can consume raw materials and create raw material lots. Permissions are set on and off by way of the toggle sliders for each. For the demo role we just created, I will turn on all the permissions in the work order execution category. Once you've set the permissions for the role, click Create to save your changes. Your newly created role will appear at the end of the list. It is now available to be added to assignments. To make changes to an existing role, click the pencil icon in the Actions column for the role you want to change. This will bring up the Role Detail page, which works the same as the Create Role page we saw earlier. Once you've made your desired changes, click Update. To delete a role, click the X in the Actions column for the role you want to delete, and confirm that you want to delete the role. This concludes the User Roles Management demo. Thank you for watching.